Hi friends, this is Rajinikanth, Excel Guru, and these many days I was very busy in my schedule. For that reason I am unable to upload any sort of Excel videos. Now I try to complete A11 to A20. Okay, if you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment box. Right, and I have already completed A21 to A30. If anybody wants this, they can go to it. Below this video, I will upload this file for your test. Okay, now A11 to A20. What I said, I want to count only the unique values. Only the unique values. Okay, here it is a 3. Okay, here it is a 3. But it should consider 3 as 1 only, not 2 times. It should be only 1. 1, 3, 1, 6, 1, 5, 1, 4. It may be duplicates. The duplicate should not be considered. Only the unique value should consider. And they should count. Okay. See how I'll do. Frequency. If this is, you are not interested in blanks. So I'm giving. This range is not equal to blank, then match of this F4. Match will expecting only the single value, but I'm giving more than value, so it considered as an array function. Okay, I'm close parenthesis exact match and close parenthesis. Now bins array. In my previous video I explained you why I'm using this type of bins. Okay, if you want, you can go through it and check it once. Okay, now I will press F9 to evaluate. Okay, F9. See, 3 is repeating 5 times, so duplicate will show as 0. 6 is repeating 3 times, so duplicate will consider as a 0. If it is duplicate, okay, see here duplicate, so it consider as a 0. 6 and 5 2 times, and second 5 considered as a 0. Okay, so I want to count these things. Okay, add unique values. Okay, just go through by sum product, it will add automatically. Okay, sum product can handle array, just press enter. No, see, it's not considering. So you have to press Ctrl Shift and enter. Okay. So some people will get a doubt that how can we count? Okay. As to how can we count how many numbers are there? Okay. We added, but we have to know how many are numbers. Okay. Simply use count. F9. So it is not showing proper answer. Okay, because 0 is also a number, so it is counting 0 also. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to make it all numbers into 1s, all these numbers into 1s. Okay, then only you can able to count. How you will do. Okay, so guys, sorry for interruption. So guys, here it is. Okay, so you have to count. It's already are there 5, 3, 2 always. You have to count how many are there. See, if you will use count, it will not give a proper answer, because 0 is also a number. So for that reason, you have to use a special function called sign. Sign will convert numbers into ones and zero numbers as 0. And non-zero numbers as 1. If you want, you can check it by pressing F9. Now easily you can use by sum product. Okay, so it will consider as an array function, so you have to use Ctrl Shift and Enter. So total unique values are 6. Okay, here also the same thing, just copy this old function, come to here F2, Ctrl V, and change this one, the ranges. See how I'll change this. That's it, because here also blanks are there, So we are not interested in blanks, okay? We are not interested in blanks, so just remove that one and remove this one also. Control shift and enter. Here see what it will give the correct answer, 10. Okay, same procedure, okay? Don't get confused between this, okay? Now, what I said, you have to match these two letters to get a country name. To match these two letters to get a country name. It is very easy, guys. It's very easy by using index. First of all, what I'll do, match this ampersand. I'm joining these two. F9. So what it will give you, sorry, only this one. F9. So it will give you again. Okay. So what will be the lookup array? Take the first one, whichever you've taken. See, I is present over in the first row. So you have to select this one. Ampersand, second one, comma, zero, exact match, F9. See, it is showing one. So index got the row number, okay, sorry, column number, okay, index, the row, it got the row number, sorry, I did not select this one, select this one, F4, comma, C, index got the row number, F9, 1, okay, just close this parenthesis, enter, it will give you the value because it's an array function. You have to use control shift and enter. Go to the U, nothing is there. US is there, US, see, America. Okay, US, America. Right, guys? Okay, for your clarification, I try to do with conditional format. Okay, so I move this little bit upwards. Wait a minute, guys, to make you better understand, okay, see, US, okay, so I will use only this function, here, the magic of match, control C, I select this 3, because we need this 3, okay, Alt HBA, okay, so I will copy this function over here, F2, not F2, control B, it will be all the match, F2 equal to, what I'll do here, see guys, what I'll do here, I'll keep equal to, C should move down, sorry, 17 should move 18 should do, to move no, 19, but C should not move anywhere, so I lock only the C, here also the same thing, I lock only the D. Here I lock all those things because it should not move anywhere. Okay, it should not move anywhere. Right, it has to check in between this only. Okay, let's check by pressing Control Shift and Enter. Yes, 3, 3, 3. Okay, right. F2. Now, those. D dollar 19 colon D 19 equal to, okay, you have to use control shift enter. See what will happen. See, okay, I did somewhere wrong. Wait a second, guys, it's showing proper answer only. Sorry, it is moving from here to here, it should not move, right? Which one I should lock, this one, right? Okay, should lock this one. It should not move, right? It has to sit here. When it comes to here, what will happen? Yes, it has to become a true, guys. Wait a minute, it has to become true. I don't know why it is showing. Wait a minute, guys. Wait a minute. That's to move down. That's the downwards, not column. Downwards. Not column. Column should not move. Okay, column should not move. Only downwards should move. Okay, now let me check. It has to come true actually. False. No, no, it has to come, guys. It has to come true. Because someday something wrong, guys. The procedure is correct. Let's try in another way. Is equal to this. I'm locking the column but not the row. Is equal to this, locking every side. This is the one, so you have to use AND. We need two. Okay, this is another logical function. F4, lock the column but not the row, is equal to this. F4, it's all already selected. When I press Ctrl Enter, it will populate selected table. Okay, see, so here is showing this true. Okay, F2, Ctrl C, Alt HLN, shortcut key for conditional format. Page down, Tab, Ctrl V, format as you required. It may be yellow, red, or red, yellow, whatever it may be. But I prefer every time I prefer this one only. Automatic red bold. Okay. If I change this to another one, I N. See. If I change to another one, like MY. Okay, MY Malaysia. Okay. See. Okay. Now coming to 13th part. Find working hours. Okay, 13 now. Okay, find working hours. How you find working hours? A, B, C, D. Already I did this one. See, guys, already I did this one. If you want, you can go through my assignment and you'll find the formula over there. Okay. Now coming to down. Get values from a table. 1, 2, here is table, here is the names or something. Okay, you have to get those values as per this. Okay, by VLOOKUP I'll do. Okay, by VLOOKUP. Okay, is equal to VLOOKUP, is equal to VLOOKUP. This one, locking the column but not the row. Come to here, this is down arrow, F4, comma, 2. Everybody knows 2. Okay, but see the magic, guys. It will give you only the one. Okay, only one, but we need two. Okay, we need two. Okay, so here is the magic. Select those cells. We need 2 and 3. Keep in curly brackets. That call array constant 2, 3. Close curly brackets. Control Enter. It will not give the proper answer. F2, Control Shift and Enter. See now. D7, 8. Double click from here. A12. B34. B34. C56. Okay, guys. And coming to another 16. Not very 16. Wait a minute, guys. 16. Okay. What I said, the name should repeat as many as times like this. Okay. See the magic. If rows, open the bracket, $83, colon A83. Okay, if it is greater than 7, it is greater than 7, comma, show me the blank. If it is greater than 7, else give me this excel. F4. It's a normal function, just press enter. Let's check, guys, it will work or not. Okay, it is in here. see now the magic, 7 times. We'll just we'll count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If we change to 5, if we change to Guru, if we change to 2, so simple. Okay, now coming to extract that many X count. Extract that many X count. What is that? Let's try. Okay. Okay. Extract how many X count? Okay, something wrong over here. Just a minute. Okay. Like this sentence. Okay. It's a picture. So where it is? The data should be here now. It's a picture. Okay, 17. Okay, some missing guys here. 24, 19. Some missing here. Let me check. Okay, come to here. Some missing over there. Okay, here is an amazing thing. I want to sort in a single column by formula. Here it is 2. Here it is 2. I want to sort in a single value with a formula or a function. Okay, with a formula or a function. I want to sort. Okay. Is equal to, everyone know small, open the bracket, we can take an array. Here I will give double arrays. So many less people will know this one. Okay, comma, F4, close current. I have given two arrays. Now, simply rows, open the bracket, C$115, colon C115. Okay, that's it. Simply press enter. It's not an array function. Simply press enter. See. So easy, guys. The thing you have to understand is what is that? What is what? That's it. Okay. Can drag this formula till end. See. Okay. So simple. 20. Add, count, and extract the number which is below 50. Wow. Okay, only below 50. First of all, we have to add, and we have to know how many are there below 50, and what are the numbers are there below 50. These three things we have to do. First, we have to add. Okay, so what you will do is equal to, this is an array function, guys. This is an array function. Control shift down arrow, F4, below 50, less than 50, F9. So it's an array function, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 4. Just now I said that convert is a true out there. So you have to use double negative. So true will become 1. True will become 1. Instead of 50, I use this one, I use this one. So true will become 1. False will become 0. Easily you can count how many are there by sum product. Sum product, okay. Sum product. If you try totally it, yes, it is right. If you want, you can go through it and simply just copy this formula from here. Whole formula, control C, escape, F2, control V, into again this one, F4, enter, 199. Okay. How it will become 199? I'll remove this negative also. It will, nothing will change, nothing will happen. Here the ones are there. In my previous video I explained, you see. All numbers below 50. Okay. Control Z, 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 Control Y. Okay, I press Control X instead of Control Y. Okay. Simply nothing will happen. Leave it off like that. Okay, just I'll copy this one. Only I need this part. Okay, only this part. Control C, escape is equal to index. What you need, this one. Control shift down arrow, F4, comma, small, F2, small, if. Control V. If less than 50, so open the bracket. down arrow F4 minus rho, open the bracket. The first one you have to take A143 F4, lock it from all sides, plus 1, okay, and K will be rows, open 1, 2, 3 like that I need, okay, D colon 147 colon 147. All are easy answers, just you have to use minimum of your knowledge. Control shift enter, here something went wrong, somewhere something went wrong, where it is, small. Okay, I did not get D over here, D. All are below 50. Okay. If we change to 40, let's see. All are 60, yes. All are totally 6 are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Totally count this much. The total this much. Okay, guys. Thank you, guys. Thanks for your support. Have a nice day. And I'm attaching A21 to A30 with this file. Okay, I'm attaching this solution file as well as this. You have to try by yourself. Okay, guys. Thank you, guys. Thanks for your support. Bye-bye.